Hey guys, so it's pretty dark in here, but I'm going to show you kind of the state of our garage. Now, some stuff we've already started moving just to play around with what we think we're going to do. Since we've moved in, we've known that we need to do something with storage. We don't have enough storage in the house, and we're just trying to really this year to focus on making more space with the house that we have. This wall is mostly my storage organizing bins that I saved from previous projects. I like to keep them because you always have access to different bins whenever you're doing a project. And I'm not going to get rid of all of them. I do think I am going to have to get rid of some of them because they take up a lot of room. I may not have to, but we'll see. I'm preparing myself for the fact that I am probably going to have to get rid of some of them. A long time ago, we found this countertop and these cabinets on the side of the road. So we brought those in the house and have been using them, but still, it's just not a good situation. We've got tons of junk over there. The bikes are actually behind that big pile of stuff. There's always stuff in the floor. This little thing here, we used to be up against the wall. It's the girls' outdoor toys, my husband's fishing stuff, garage type things, ladders, painting supplies, the lawnmower, all that stuff. So what we're planning on doing is making basically custom shelves for this entire wall. And we're gonna start one section at a time. The first section we're gonna do is an L-shaped section right here. We decided to put it over here instead of over there for several reasons, but the main one being we already couldn't use the vertical space right here because of the breaker box. So I thought that makes the most sense to put it over there because we already can't use that space. So this is gonna change a little bit. And then the shelf desk area is supposed to go right here. That's gonna be one separate piece. Then coming over here, we're gonna have another piece that is built for the dimensions of this section. And we have to stop there because of the track of the garage. And then this section is gonna be another sized piece. So that's the plan for this side. Over here, like I said, it's just a big old mess. But some of this stuff hopefully will have a better home once we start working on this side. But I wanted to show you a before we moved anything else around, even though we've already moved a couple things, just to kind of give you an idea of what we're working with, what we are gonna try to do, and some video along the way of progress of how we're doing it. So definitely if you wanna see kind of our journey along with this process, what we're doing, how it worked out, how much more space we're able to add, and how I organize it, then stay tuned. Okay, so it's been a few hours and he is done with this section except for organizing it. As the reason we needed this counter to be so deep is we had to have room for all of his big outdoor things. So his lawnmower, his blower, his shop vac, and his pressure washer, and his car ramps all fit underneath there. And we just had to pull the van out whenever he mows. So it goes in from this side. So that seemed like the best way to utilize the space and still give him a workbench and still make the best use of this corner. Okay, so here is a progress update on the shelf. It's exciting that it's almost done. As you can see here up at the top, we had to drop down because of the garage door track. The next time I see you guys, hopefully the plywood will be on and then I can really start working on organizing it. After quite a few weeks and a lot of work, it is finally done in here in the garage. I'm so excited with how it turned out, and I'm gonna show you guys kind of everything we have set up here. There is so much that is stored in just this one little corner of the garage. It's amazing how much stuff I was able to take out of the house that was shoved under beds and in different closets and was able to put out here everything together. I made sure to designate a special spot for donations and things I want to sell. There is extra room with room to grow for things for the girls that I'm saving for their kids and for memories. So I'm going to show you everything. So I think obviously the main focal point and the main change in this room is this wall, which you saw it before, what a mess it was. And I tried to reuse as many of the bins that I already had, which is why they don't all match. I had to shut the door because the neighbor lady was watching me weirdly. I wish all the bins matched, but I wasn't going to go out and buy bins I didn't have to just so they would all match. So most of them do match. Obviously those two don't, that one doesn't, and those three don't. Those I already had, so I just decided to go ahead and use them. I did purchase all of these gray ones here, these bigger ones. I had those two already, and then I purchased these three, so they all match. And then I have all these. They look kind of intentional, but they were actually bins that I already had. Starting up here at the very top, we have things that we need to get to the least. So beach toys, the inflatable bounce house that we have, the mats for the tent right there, and then we have some more beach toys and an inflatable birthday cake that we only use every now and again for somebody's birthday. On the next shelf, I have All of these bins right here, I got rid of a lot of my storage containers, but I kept as many as I could because it's always good to have those things. So when you're doing an organizing project, you don't have to go out and buy everything brand new. These bins actually hold a lot. They're from Container Store. I think the patterns are discontinued, but I think they still sell this type of bin. And so these are all storage bags and storage bean bags. Organizing bins. I did go ahead and put my old VHS tapes and some of our DVD cases that I wanted to keep up there, and I put it behind this pole because obviously that's the hardest one to get to and I never hardly use that. And then these two right here are also more storage bins. In the back behind this row, I have a couple little bins just kind of sitting up vertically, just out of the way. You can't even see them, but those are up there as well. And then on this side, I do have this little table and chair set that my girls had when they were little. For now, I'm gonna keep it in here at some point. I think my mom and dad are gonna put them in their attic. But for now, they are staying right there. And then I also have a countertop from my girls' homeschool desks I wanted to save. If we ever decide to change the configuration of the desks, we do have an extra desktop. Then going all across this entire row, these are all baby clothes and clothes that my kids have grown out of that I wanted to keep. A lot of times I cut them up into scraps and I'll have them made into a blanket. And then there's some things that aren't cut up that I just wanted to keep because I'm sentimental. You can call me a hoarder if you want, but I just really wanted to keep a lot of those. So all of these containers are baby clothes. So all of these, and then this one right here and that one right there. Those are all clothes that the girls have grown out of that I wanted to keep. Inside these containers, they are all vacuum sealed with space bag type of things. I actually get a different brand from Amazon, but same kind of concept where you suck the air out so you're able to store a lot more in the container and hopefully keeping them bug safe and all that stuff. So all of those containers have baby clothes. This is actually two containers that are just like these stacked up here. I wanted to go ahead and get at least two more. That way, if I change configuration of the shelves or if I need more room at some point, I've got two extra ones that match, because what ends up happening to me is they end up discontinuing certain colors and they wouldn't match. So I have these two extra ones just in case, but right now they are empty. And then these two bins I already had as well. They are some books that I wanted to keep for the girls for whenever they grow up. If they want to keep them and use them for their kids, I have books there and baby shoes. Down here at the bottom, I already had these two containers and they are full of baby toys that I wanted to keep, again, of the girls that they may want someday for their own kids. They are full. There's no more room to put any more toys in these two, but that's okay. I've got some room to grow down on the end and I'll show you that in a minute. I went ahead and put another bin down here. These are all clothes that are my oldest daughter's that my youngest daughter has not grown into yet. So she can wear them at some point if she wants when she gets older. So that is why that's there. If I had my way, I would have put toy container, toy container, toy container, toy container, toy container, and then put the growing into basket down there at the end. But that would not fit right here. And I'm also working with a pipe back there that sticks out from the wall. And if I had to put that right here, it would have stuck out really far in the floor, even farther than it already does. So I went ahead and put that one right there. So that is where I know to go whenever a new season comes and I'm gonna be getting clothes for my youngest to see what she's gonna need. I go into this box first and I can see, you know, what did my older daughter have that she's outgrown that maybe my younger daughter can wear. And then down here on the bottom, as you see, it says toys empty, toys empty. That one I haven't labeled yet because I just picked it up. It was the last one Target had. These are empty. There are no toys in there, but there are going to be very soon because our next big project is going to be the playroom and packing away things that they are just not playing with. And then over here, I just have another baby toy. It was my oldest when she was little. And I'm saving that for my grandkids one day. And again, same thing with the table up here. At some point, my parents are going to be putting some of our stuff in long-term storage in their attic. And that's when that will go up there as well. For now, it's not hurting anything. It's not in the way. That's a perfect little spot for it, so I'm not really in a hurry to get rid of it. And then right here, I have these two bins. That one is definitely seeing better days. It's got some tape on the top. But again, I already had these, and I wanted to make sure that I left room in my garage for things I want to sell and things I want to donate. And that's really important because if you don't leave a spot for that, then whenever you have something to sell or donate, you end up throwing it in the garage, or you throw it in your car, or you shove it in a closet somewhere, and it's just taking up space where it really shouldn't be. So make sure when you're organizing, if possible, and you do a lot of selling or donating of things, that you have a designated spot for those things to go into.
Okay, so. And then going over here, we just have a few things, outside toys for the girls. We have our outdoor picnic blanket. We have a couple toss games here, an old helmet that I actually did not know was there. I need to sell that. My daughter's bow and arrow, and then we have bug type things and binoculars. So any of the little bug catcher things that they have, they keep for the bugs, and then binoculars. Here we have an outdoor laser tag game, and of course every girl should have a bin labeled weapons, but it's basically like darts and those little things that you shoot and all that stuff. Here on the shelf, I went ahead and labeled balls because behind this is a container full of balls. We have sidewalk chalk, bubbles and kites, and jump ropes. And then here I have bubble solution and rocks. Again, behind this little stack here, there's a little box full of rocks that my girls wanted to keep for collecting. And bubble solution is right here. So I have two of these bottles whenever we need to refill the bubbles. That's where that is. And then in between these two containers, I just have all of their bug little habitats that you get when you get like those butterfly kits and stuff. We like to keep these because they're always saving moths and butterflies and collecting grasshoppers and stuff like that. So all of the outdoor things fit right here. Another really big change to the garage, and one of the reasons why we were actually really seriously considering getting an outdoor shed, which they're not cheap, is because we didn't think we could make a shelf like this because we had all of these outdoor things. He's got a pressure washer and a blower and a shop vac and a bunch of tools and the lawnmower and all that stuff, and we didn't know where we were going to put any of that. I wanted a workbench, and I was like, there's just not room out here. But I was like, what if we go ahead, elevate the workbench enough that we can actually slide those things underneath so he gets his workbench, and then we still have room for all the things that he needs when he's doing lawn work. We put some wire shelves. We already had those. We just cut them down to fit so he could put some of his toolboxes and some of his accessories for his Dremel and his fishing stuff and his RC cars that he's into. He made this little thing here to hold all of his screwdrivers and things. He went ahead and mounted the power strip right here, so anything he wants to leave plugged up can stay right there. He added a shop light up here. We've got the pegboard right here, which he organized and has it the way that he wants it. And then up here at the very top, we just have another shelf that he put up there. We already had, he just cut it down to fit, and it's got all of the chassis for his RC cars. He also put these little strips here that hold all of those little, whatever those are. I don't even know what those are for, but these little things here he mounted there. We have a trash bag for outdoor trash. And then like I said, we even put another shelf right here because the lawnmower is right there and it pushes right underneath this shelf. And so that shelf is stuff that we don't use very often. So power tools and some engine oil for something he's got, I don't really know. But all this stuff we don't use very often because that's why it's in the most difficult to reach area. But it is still accessible while being out of the way. He also hung the tape measures, which we were always losing. Actually, one of them's upstairs right now, but they have a home now. They're easily accessible. And that way, hopefully, we will not keep losing them if they are right there and they have a home and everybody knows where they go. And that's why he put those hooks there for those. And then he just has his hat that he wears when he mows outside. Okay, on the other side, another really big change that we made. If you saw my laundry room reorganization video that I did, that whole thing was kind of inspired by this project because used to, I had two shelves full of cleaning products that really I wanted to have in the house, but I didn't have room for them in the house. So that's why they used to live out here. Thankfully, with the changes that we made in there, and if you guys haven't seen that video, you definitely should go check it out. I was able to get all of my cleaning products, except for a few oversized bottles, in the house. So that left room for things that I wanted to be in the garage. Starting up here, we have homeschool papers from years we've already completed. And obviously, you know, I wish I could put that in the house somewhere, but it's not something I really need to have that accessible. It's something I need to keep, but I don't need to have accessible, and I don't access it really hardly ever. So those just stay up there. We've got room for one more right here, and there's some more room in the back for extra for future years. But that's where those have been, and that's where they will probably stay for the foreseeable future. This shelf is all paper products. So toilet paper, paper towels, tissues, and then I have trash bags right here. On the next shelf, I just have any air filters for our house. And then these three bins actually used to be in my laundry room. I use them for storage in there. Now they are staying out here because they fit perfectly. They're really durable. And I figured I might as well use them. This one is for mailing supplies. So when I have packing envelopes and packing bubbles and all that stuff, so that's what's gonna live in there.
This one is all for product boxes. So boxes of things I want to keep. So like our ring for our front door, our stand for our Google Home thing, my laptop box and stuff like that. Those all live in this box. And then over here, I have all space bags and shopping bags. So these are the space bags that I say space bags. I realize space bag is a brand. These vacuum seal bags, Space Saver, are the ones that I've gotten most recently from Amazon. I think they're a lot better than space bags, at least so far. They've been holding up really well. I have some extra ones of those. And then I also have any shopping bags. So if you're going to the grocery store and you want to take a reusable bag, I keep all of those reusable type bags in here. And in the very back, which this is not going to be that way forever. Normally, I don't have bottles that big of laundry detergent, but we used to have a Costco membership, and those two bottles are left from that. Once those are gone, though, all my laundry detergent will fit in my laundry room where they should be. And then I have, same situation, an extra bottle of Lysol all-purpose cleaner that I got when I had our Costco membership, and it's just going to live back there until that bottle is empty. Down here, I have the girls and my husband's skate bag. Prior to quarantine, they were going skating, you know, once or twice a week, and they all have skate bags. This is a really good place to keep them. They're accessible to them, and they have their own home, so they're not just throwing them in a closet or something somewhere. And then in the back here, I labeled knee pads. There's just extra knee pads back there in that little container. So that's all skating things. And then down here in the bottom, I have anything outdoors. So I have my umbrella, my extra umbrella. I have garden flags. I've got my hand clippers and my garden gloves, and there's some bird seed and some corn for the squirrels. And then I have a few miscellaneous things for our guinea pig. So her travel carrier and her pellets. This area is definitely not attractive or glamorous at all. It's basically just our recycling. Unfortunately, that's kind of where it has to stay until our recycling people come once a week. We just kind of, because we've got the kitchen door right there, so we just kind of put it out here, and then once a week we take all this, dump it in the recycling can, and then the people come and take it. And then we actually hung our oldest daughter's bike right there, and that's the HVAC closet right there. Okay, on the next shelf, I can't show you everything because it's got the girls' names on them, so I'm just going to tell you what's in the next shelf. It's a shelf just like this one. They're right side by side, and I have 12 of these clear bins from Target, and basically they are all full of the girls' artwork. Things they have made for me over the years, or things they've done just in general. Anything they draw, yes, again, I'm sentimental and I want to keep a lot of that stuff. So this cabinet is plenty of room. It should be plenty of room to keep all of their artwork until they are out of the house. And then up here right now, I have Bean's old cage. It's actually a rabbit cage. It's the cage she used to have. She's got a much bigger cage now, but we wanted to keep her cage that she had just in case if we go on vacation or something, and it makes it easier for the person who's watching her to have this versus the one we have now. The one we have now has a soft bottom on it and you can't really carry it anywhere. This one's a hard plastic one. So for now, it's gonna live up there. My mom actually said she is going to put that in her attic as well, but she hasn't yet. But for now, it's there. At some point when that cage is gone, that is where our cushions from our outdoor patio furniture are going to stay. It's just right now they're out there on the patio because it's summertime. When the wintertime comes, we will give that to her to put in her attic, and then all of our cushions for our outdoor chairs will fit on top of there. We did hang our youngest daughter's bike right there on the wall as well. And then here on top of my husband's safe, we just have any type of lunch bag. So we have his lunch bag he takes for work sometimes. We have our car refrigerator we use for our trip to Disney. And then he has some kind of bag back there. I have no idea what it is. And then these are insulated bags for taking food or anything back and forth. That's pretty much it. I'm really excited with how it turned out. It definitely was a big job, and I really honestly can't believe we did it. It's actually really inexpensive, and everything we bought, totes and all the wood and everything together, still did not cost as much as it would have cost to get an outdoor shed that was actually any decent size. So I'm really happy with how it turned out. I know it's not HGTV worthy, maybe. For me it is. For me, I think it's beautiful and I love it. But I try to be as realistic as possible when I share organizing things with you guys, because a lot of us don't have huge budgets. A lot of us don't want to have to go out and buy all new bins for every project that match and are perfect for a space. I really try to make things work that I have and spend as little as possible. And that's one reason why I was so adamant about, you know, using bins that maybe they don't match. You know, if I was a professional organizer, they wouldn't come in here probably and mix colors and things. But
For me, that's not realistic. I'm not going to waste all that money I already spent on totes and things like that. So we did a really good job, I think, at keeping the costs as low as possible, being really creative with the space that we had to work with, and finding a home for literally everything we had in this garage. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not already. I will also link my entire cleaning and organizing playlist for you in the description box. Every cleaning video and organizing video I've ever made is in that playlist. I think you'll get lots of inspiration from that. And I hope you guys will check it out and subscribe if you're not already. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.